Oh, here we go. Pushing hands from a distance. Right? Good. Get your cover hand up, Sandy. Is it up? Good. I just can't see it. So you don't have to be connected to push hands. And let's see if you can step into each other's center and then drag the heel back. You'll get more exercise on the back leg. And drag the heel back and step in. Good, very good. So there's three hand positions. There's the yang, the push. Get your interim position in there a little better, Steve, with the ward off. Palm faces you. Yeah, spend a little more time in palm, with your palm facing you. Good, Sandy. And palm faces you. Good. And then palm faces the ceiling. Good. Three palm positions. Good. So when the back leg gets tired, let's assume your back leg is tired. Switch legs, switch hands. Good. Same thing, other side. See if you can switch the information to your other hand. Make sure you go through your palm facing yourself, Steve. Go through your palm. That's the most important, is your ward off position. Half steps, and do it until your back leg feels nice and cooked. Good. Let the blood just flood into that back leg muscle. That's a good old Tai Chi feeling. Yeah. And exhale forward, inhale back. See if you can time it with your breathing. Get into a nice rhythm with it. Remember to keep your elbow up a little bit in your pung position, in your ward off position. You're missing the ward off on your right side, Sandy. Go through position number 2 and then 3. Nice, Steve. Ward off to Lou to roll back. Very good.